We all learned it in school. When it comes to sex and gender, women have two X chromosomes and men have XY, and that's all there is to it, right? Is anything really that simple on this show? Hello everyone, Crystal here with DNews. Science has known for a while that it's possible for humans to be born with more or less than two sex chromosomes. These unusual combinations are rare in the human population and in most cases are not something you inherit from your parents, but from an error during meiosis leading to an inappropriate number of sex chromosomes in human gametes. Yes. Yes, think back to high school biology. Usually, mature eggs and sperm carry only one sex chromosome. In the case of sperm, either an X or a Y. When exceptions to this rule occur, it leads to chromosomal abnormalities. For instance, Turner syndrome occurs in individuals who carry only one sex chromosome, an X. These individuals express the physical characteristics of a human female, but they're frequently unable to have children and have a lower life expectancy because that single X chromosome is doing the work of two, and the information contained on that one X is less robust. Often, pregnancies to Turner syndrome babies don't make it to delivery. Superfemales are the opposite. They have an extra X. There's usually no distinguishable difference to the naked eye between those with triple X and the rest of the female population, but some studies based on small samples have correlated exceptional height, learning disabilities, and weak muscle tone to triple X individuals. Similar abnormalities involving the Y chromosome are also possible. Although a Y-only permutation is fatal, combinations such as XXY, XYY, XXYY, and others do also occur with variable frequency. These individuals express male traits and secondary sex characteristics due to the presence of the SRY gene, which is carried on the Y chromosome. But what happens when that gene migrates to another chromosome? Can it do that? Can an X chromosome express the gene that makes male parts? Well, science says actually yes. Recent studies, including one performed at Arizona State University, have shown that sex chromosomes, like our other 22 pairs of chromosomes, experience recombination. All you really need to know about genetic recombination is that while making sperm and eggs, our bodies replicate our chromosomal DNA and then sort single copies of those physical records of genetic information into eggs or sperm that carry half of the set of instructions needed for a healthy human. This includes a single sex chromosome, X or Y. When the copying process occurs, near identical chromosomal pairs are smushed together in a way that they can become tangled, and sometimes identical parts of those chromosomes can get shifted around from one to the other. This tangled mixing is called recombination, and errors in this process are a contributing factor to genetic variation and evolution. But wait, you say, sex chromosomes are not identical, and therefore they don't have similar gene sequences to tangle together and recombine. Well, actually they do. Only the very ends of the X and Y chromosomes contain enough similarity to stick together and swap genes during meiosis, but that's enough similarity to get the SRY gene tangled up in the process. Gene migration is not uncommon, but when the gene responsible for the male phenotype ends up on the chromosome responsible for a female phenotype, things get pretty complicated. This condition, called XX male or de la Chapelle syndrome, is relatively rare, occurring in something like 5 in every 100,000 individuals. The individuals carry the female XX chromosomal signature, but they develop like men, although their testes are small and they are usually sterile. XX male syndrome was identified in the 1970s, but it's only now that we're starting to understand the mechanism of how this condition occurs. What we can learn from this is that while the sex chromosomes we carry do determine a lot of our outward appearance and reproductive characteristics, it's frustratingly not always that simple, and chromosomal composition is not the last word in gender phenotype. The past couple of weeks on DNews and on our spin-off show Test 2 Plus, we've talked a lot about sex and gender. If you want to hear another take on the subject, check out this video from our good friends at Wisecrack. They recently uploaded an episode of 8-Bit Philosophy called, Is Gender Real?
According to American philosopher Judith Butler, these conversations miss an important point. Gender is a lot messier than we'd like to think. Gender is a sort of script that society expects us to act out.
Again, it's a great video and we're huge fans of their channel, so make sure you subscribe. If you're on mobile, click the first link in the description to watch. For now though, let us know what you think about the complicated tangle of genetics and gender by subscribing to DNews and adding to the comments down below. Thanks for watching.